Hi, welcome to Elegant Sophistication. I'm Jacqueline St. James. In your quest to find your signature scent, keep in mind that it is just as important to your outward style as having tailored clothes and pairing the correct tie with the appropriate shirt. However, most men simply just wear a scent that was given to them as a gift or bought hastily from that cute sales guy or girl offering tote bags and beach towels at department stores. This results in a lot of men wearing copious amounts of tobacco and coriander-laced colognes that just don't mix well with natural pheromones. To find your signature scent, you'll have to do a little research, but the results usually pay off in spades before or when you find the right fragrance. Before you make that mistake of using the same cologne your dad used to use, let me help you figure out how to find your signature scent. The first step in knowing how to find your signature scent is to understand what type of skin you have, whether it's oily or dry. Just as body hair keeps the scent of a cologne close to you, oily skin enhances and amplifies your cologne. Moist and oily skin responds best to a lighter citrus-based scent because these elements help to balance out the stronger natural odors that your skin is secreting. Stay with airy or summertime scents for a fresher feeling. Try this scent. For dry skin tones, cologne needs something to adhere to, and dry or sensitive skin does not hold a scent as long as oily skin. Contrary to popular beliefs, putting on more of any scent is just not the answer. Instead, try a heavier or thicker scent with undertones of tobacco and musk. These have a greater presence and will stay with you longer than lighter fragrances. Try this scent here. Choosing the right scent is not always about what smells good in a magazine. You also have to consider your lifestyle to narrow down your option as you try to find your signature scent. For example, do you prefer spicy foods? Do you consume large amounts of alcohol regularly? Or do you smoke? What you ingest comes to the surface of your skin in perspiration, blending with the cologne you wear, and adds to the fragrance that swirls around you. One aspect of choosing a signature scent that is often overlooked is the setting in which you plan to wear it in. A scent that's fit for the office is not appropriate for nights prowling at the local clubs. If you plan on to wear one scent on a daily basis, then you're really looking for a balanced fragrance that fits your overall lifestyle. Whatever you do, don't let the sales clerk at the counter spray anything on you. I mean, get back. Good God, I can't stand that. If she doesn't offer to spray a sample on a card for you to smell, then ask her to do so. If the store doesn't have cards, you need to go elsewhere to get your signature scent. After a few samples, your nose won't know what it's supposed to be smelling. When you get to this point, ask to sniff some coffee beans. Yes, coffee beans. Between various cologne options. Most well-equipped stores that you want to buy your signature scent in, have a cup of beans at the fragrance counter to sniff between sample cards to cleanse your nose. Once you have chosen a scent, let it sit for a few minutes and then smell the card again. A strong scent will linger too long and will become way over offensive. The right scent, however, will dissipate and settle into a nice, pleasant aroma. Most men need to find a new approach to matching their cologne choices to their body's own natural scent. Keep in mind that what you may find appealing may not be the best scent on you. After all, you're not wearing a fragrance to please yourself, but to enhance your presence and to be appealing to women and men who ultimately have the final say in what smells good on you. Well, I do hope this helps on your quest to find the right scent for you. Next week, we will be discussing men's fall grooming tips for the 2012 fall season. For Elegant Sophistication, I'm Jacqueline St. James, and I'll definitely see you on a runway near you. Bye for now.